double gold for Miriam Bedard, and the most watched figure skater in the universe until Nancy Kerrigan steps on the ice. Tonya Harding warming up. Debbie and Brian, interesting reaction when she stepped on the ice from the crowd.
It began with a real hush, Rod. Then people, it almost seemed as if everyone was a little bit uncomfortable. Do we applaud or do we stay quiet? She has been fighting a little bit with some shaky landings during warm-up, although we just saw quite an excellent triple Lutz, which is what she has planned for the combination.
She has a history of having poor warm-ups, but being able to pull it together for the competition, for the actual performance itself.
She has enormous power in her jumps. The speed with which she travels across the ice is, I think, the best in the world. But she can get very shaky. This is a setup for the triple Lutz. Down she goes. She wants to do the Lutz in combination because it is the most difficult. So if she is successful, she'll be getting higher marks, higher base mark.
And of course, she is known for being one of the best jumpers in this competition.
She was the first woman to ever do a triple axel in national competition when she won the title, but she has not been successful at doing any competition since then. Nancy Kerrigan will be skating 26th tonight. She is second to last. The last two flights of skaters drew their placings based on a seeding from their placements at last year's Worlds. So the first three flights, this is the number two flight, is composed of skaters who did not qualify last year.
One more attempt at the triple Lutz has been giving her some problems, and this is her last chance on the warm-up to do it, and she did a double.
This is not the time when a skater should be bashing their brains out trying to do a jump. If your work isn't done by now, it's too late.
And the advantage that she has right now is that she has a couple of skaters just to go back and get it together, reassess, and do it.
It's possible she may make the decision, or her coaches may advise her to make the decision to do a simpler combination. Clean is what it's all about. If the axle was working well, or if the Lutz was working well, fine. Another very good free skater from France is Laetitia Hubert, who kind of burst on the scene in women's skating. She finished fourth in the World Championships in Oakland, but then didn't even qualify for World Championships last year.
Really great flow going into this triple toe loop combination.
Bad lead.
And she had been she had been practicing the triple loop, and she changed this just at the last minute, which is quite often a really bad decision. Nice high double axel. Thank you.
Laetitia Hubert from Versailles. And the combination goes down to defeat again.
That address has a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
She doesn't live in a palace, though.
This was a triple tulip. Keep your eye on the right shoulder. She doesn't seem to, she lets it drop right in there, and she stays in that position. And that's what caused her to fall like that. She stayed on an angle or a lean while she was spinning. The double axel was fine, good height. She climbed into the air real nice right here. Great flow coming out.
Jumps will only work if the body stays perpendicular to the ice.
Probably reevaluating her decision to take out the triple loop and add the toe loop, which is an easier jump normally. But when you change the choreography at the last second, you're not programmed. And that's when the mistakes come up.
The marks for required elements, 4-4, 4-3, 4-4, 4-3, 4-5, 4-6, 4-6, 4-5. Thank you.
Presentation marks going up a bit. Laetitia Hubert is third behind Katrina Witt and Ivanova of Ukraine.
The marks for presentation, 4-9, 4-9, 4-9, 4-9, 4-8, 5-0, 5-1, 5-1, 4-8. Thank you.